took a mighty good man with salty hands and a mighty long raft to keep the fore before the aft. You take 10 good men and guts and luck, and you might navigate the whirl and the suck. Well, the Tennessee River changed its mind. At Chattanooga, she ought to unwind. She could have run right on to the Georgia Sea, but she cut right back through Tennessee. Well, the settlers come by raft and boat, bringing everything that'd stay afloat. But like a loco hoss that'll twist and buck, they hardly ever made it through the whirl and the suck. It took a mighty good man with salty hands and a mighty long raft to keep the fore before the aft. You take 10 good men with guts and luck, and you might navigate the whirl and the suck. General Washington was in his knicker box. The Cherokee Indians ruled the Chattanooga rocks, and the Chickamauga tribe and the Nickajack, they kept a watch where the river cut back. And if a raft or a boat ever rode the bend, the Indians got them, 'cause they had them hemmed in. It took a mighty good man with salty hands and a mighty long raft to keep the fore before the aft. You take 10 good men and guts and luck, and you might navigate the whirl and the suck.